Hello, am I audible?
Yes, Anas, go ahead. What do you want to say?
Hello, brother.
Hello, hello. Yes, hello, hello.
Yeah. So let's continue our debate.
You are debating me now?
No. I just
You
want
took me to surprise,
healthy
by the way.
debate,
I mean,
okay?
I'm not ready. I'm not
You know?
ready. If you want to debate me, you should tell me in advance so I can prepare myself. I don't know what to say now. Can I call friends to join us? Because I cannot
It's
debate
okay.
alone. Huh?
Yeah, I'm sure it's okay.
Okay,
It's
let me.
okay.
Okay.
So even I should prepare, to be honest.
I you know, this surprised me. If I know that you are coming to debate me, I know I will call some friends, but it's okay. You know what? If I mean, for now, we do it, me and you, but don't consider it as a debate because I'm weak and, you know, I'm not, and I even have cold, you know.
Okay.
Go ahead. What do you want to say to me? What is the proof that Allah is God?
Quran.
The Quran? Well, the Quran is so stupid. I told you from the beginning. Look at this God. In the first page of the Quran, Allah says, in the name of Allah. How he is talking, he says, in the name of Allah. So imagine, I'm a Christian prince, and I say, in the name of a Christian prince. But I'm a Christian prince. So if Allah is talking, how he say, in the name of Allah? Go ahead.
Okay. So can we have a healthy debate? Healthy
What
debate.
we can what?
I mean, a normal debate.
Normal debate?
Instead of abusing our holy books and all,
What
we can
abusing?
have a
My
normal
friend, I'm asking you a
debate.
question. Did I abuse anything I said? What kind of God? He's saying in the name of Allah, if he's the one who's talking.
Okay. So that's how we start with, okay? In the name of Allah. That's how we start anything.
No, no.
Bismillah.
It's not you who start. You are repeating what Allah said. It's Allah. So are you saying to me, Allah, when he starts, he say in the name of Allah, but he is Allah.
Before we start anything, listen.
I'm
Before we start
not
anything,
talking
we
about
do
you. I'm
anything.
not talking about you. This is Allah talking now, not you. Allah said, in the name of Allah.
Yeah.
How Allah say in the name of Allah if he's Allah?
That's how it's starting, sir.
No, this is not how it starts. The only crazy
Present.
people will say that. You say in the name of God if you are not God. You say in the name of the president if you are not the president. You say in the name of the king if you are not the king. But if I am the king, I will not say in the name of the king. I'm the king.
Okay, so who is delivering the message? Like, who is delivering the
No,
message?
It doesn't matter who is delivery, because simply Allah is talking, so Allah should not say in the name of Allah. Are you saying to me that this verse is not made by Allah, made by the delivery guy?
Okay, so I want to clear you something important, okay?
All right.
So listen.
Do you
the Quran is
last
written
time when
Arabic,
last
okay?
one last time when last time you received pizza and you received delivery, the guy in the pizza delivery, did he say to you in the name of banana pizza we say thank you? I mean, this is God. He sent his angel and deliver Quran from the word of Allah. The Muslim, they claim that every word there is Allah talking, so it's not the delivery guy. So how Allah says in the name, how Allah says in the name of
it's
Allah,
the big it's the beginning of the book, okay? It's the
doesn't
beginning
matter.
of the
No,
book.
This is not the beginning of the book. You're wrong. Because the first chapter Muhammad received is the squeezing chapter.
Which chapter? Sorry?
The chapter
later it was arranged, right?
The chapter of squeezing.
But it was arranged, right? It was arranged in a format.
No.
Right?
The chapter of squeezing is the first chapter Muhammad received, correct?
So third chapter came first, according to you.
No. According to you, Muslims. It's not according to me. It's not according to me. I'm talking about your religion.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're telling me that the third chapter came
yeah,
first.
So when the angel he came to Muhammad, what he did, he squeezed him, correct?
Okay.
Okay. Why he squeezed him?
What do you mean? I didn't get it, honestly.
Why he squeezed by the angel?
Squeeze?
Squeezed.
Squeezed.
Squeezed, yeah. Okay, let me help you with the sound. You know, I don't know if you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah. Go ahead.
All right.
Where?
Okay, so the prophet was squeezed by an angel. three times. And that was not the first chapter. It's now in the Quran, in chapter number 97.
Okay.
So you said to me, this is the beginning. Okay. You are squeezing the Quran now. This is not the beginning. This is not the first. In fact, there's many Quran don't even have this chapter. Like Ibn Mas'ud, he don't have this chapter. It's gone. He squeeze it. You know, you Muslims squeeze anything in your way.
Like, which chapter? You mean?
Huh?
You mean Surah Al-Fatiha, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so according to you, this is not the first chapter.
No, it's not. According to you, not according to me. According to you Muslims. According to your prophet, when the angel came to him, he told him read and he asked him and he squeezed him three times, correct?
Okay, then what happened?
Okay, this is the first chapter, but not this one. Not this one. The first chapter is where the angel, he squeezed your prophet. And by the way, why the angel squeezed your prophet? Do you know?
No, I'm sorry. I don't know.
I will tell you. The angel, he could not believe how slow Muhammad is. He told him, read. The guy said, I don't know how to read, you idiot. You know? So he squeezed him again. He told him, read, you idiot. The guy, he said, I told you I can't read. So the angel, he could not take it no more. So he squeezed him again, third time, you know. Read, you know, read. He's trying to make him read, but you cannot make someone stupid to read. In the case of Jesus, look what happened. Jesus said to the man who cannot walk, carry your bed and walk. The guy carried the bed and walk. Look how easy. He put some mud in the eye of the guy. He said to him, see. Your God, he squeezed Muhammad three times to the point Muhammad can't breathe no more. And still Muhammad do not know how to read.
Okay.
How your God can be God? If Allah is God and he said to Muhammad, read, even if Muhammad is a donkey, he will be able to read. This is what God can do. Is it the Quran says, if Allah wanted something to happen, the Quran says, if Allah wanted something to happen, he say, kun fayakun, which mean be, is going to be. All right? So he will go, Allah, he says to him, be.
Yeah.
Okay. But Muhammad, he could not make it happen. He could not make it happen.
Okay, so listen.
If Allah in chapter 2 saying, Allah, if you want something to happen, he says, be, and it's going to be. That's it. So Allah, he said to Muhammad, read three times. Was Muhammad able to read? No. The angel, he squeezed him. And he said to him again, read. He cannot read. Third time, read. Still he cannot read. And he died, he cannot read, according to Muslims. So if Allah is God, and he said to me, speak German, even though I never been in Germany, I mean, I've been in Germany, but I don't speak German, right away I would start saying, you know, because Allah, he just command, he's God, supposedly. So if he said to me, Christian Prince, speak Chinese, you know, yeah. So now, because Allah is God, he said to me, speak Chinese, even though I never spoke Chinese before, I would speak Chinese. But Allah, he said to Muhammad three times with a squeezing. I mean, I don't know what the squeezing would do, but I heard that some prophet need to be activated, you know. So Allah squeezed him, still nothing working. Squeeze him again, nothing working. Third time, nothing work. By the way, why three times, not four times? Maybe if Allah tried the fourth time, it would work. What do you think?
Okay, go ahead.
No, I'm asking you. Why Allah, he squeezed Muhammad three times, not four?
Listen. Okay, will you listen to me 1 minute?
I will listen to you three times. Go ahead, three times.
Okay. So let's have a normal debate. Okay, listen. The thing is, I'm not as knowledgeable as you. Okay, about my religion and your religion. So, how we are gonna proceed is, you ask me a question. If I answer it, we'll forward, or we can go to next question. Okay. And same goes to you. Okay.
There's no squeezing. Squeezing involved. Should we squeeze or no squeeze?
No squeeze. Okay.
Why not?
We're just gonna talk normal, okay? If I know the answer, I'll follow.
Are you saying to me that your God did not do something normal when he squeezed Muhammad? Are you insulting the Prophet of Allah now? Why are you doing that? You keep saying to me, normal, normal, normal. That means Muhammad being squeezed is not normal. So what was the point? Why he squeezed him?
Honestly, I don't know the meaning of squeeze, okay?
Squeeze mean the sound. This is squeeze. Squeeze like beep, beep, beep. You know, squeeze somebody. You know?
Okay, so squeeze means sound.
No, squeezing is like putting your arms around somebody, squeezing him. Like you know what squeezing means? You speak English, come on, man. So, guys, somebody tell him what squeezing means.
I speak
mean.
Normal English.
You don't speak English?
Actually, I speak multiple languages. So
yeah, but
I'm
don't you know what
English.
Don't you know what squeeze mean?
No, actually. I know a normal meaning, like squeeze means press or something.
Oh yeah, press. Thank you. That's the word. You know, the angel, he squeezed him. He put his arm around him and he pressed on him so hard. And for sure, Muhammad will fall because you are squeezing the guy. So the angel is strong, very strong, you know, like, you know, for me, last time I have a fight with the, you know, angels, I hit him in his eye and I took his eye and because I play karate. And then he went to Allah and he asked Allah to repair it. What do you think about my story?
Okay, honestly, listen. Honestly, I don't know about the squeezing thing, okay? I learn and tell you, okay? If it's a mistake, mistake. If it's not a mistake, then I'll talk to you in next debate or something, okay? Now,
okay,
can
okay.
we move to another topic? Listen.
What topic?
Okay, so listen. I respect Christianity, okay?
I don't respect my friend,
Listen.
I'm not asking you to respect anything. And I don't respect Islam. Do you respect stupidity?
Okay.
Do you respect stupidity?
Well, I respect my own.
I don't respect stupidity. So what your prophet, he says that Allah, he sent an angel and he squeezed him 3 times. And then Muhammad could not even breathe. All right? And what's the point of this?
Right? Listen. The Bible is perfect, right?
According to the Quran, it is, yeah.
So actually, we believe in Injil, but not Bible. I'm sorry.
No, we are believing in Injil. Injil is a word we as Arab Christian we use it, and even Latin people. This is a Latin word.
You speak Arabic?
No, I'm from Afghanistan. Where are you from?
Wait, what?
Where are you from? I'm from Afghanistan.
Actually, I'm. Okay. That's great.
What, great? Afghanistan is great? The most stupid dog in the world is Afghani dog.
No, actually, people... So, you know Taliban, right?
Taliban? I mean, the name alone is funny.
Because...
Those are the one...
You live in Afghanistan,
the one who said that a woman cannot... Taliban is the one who said a woman she cannot sit in a chair because a chair is a male? Those are the smart...
See, are you really from Afghanistan? Are you really
no, you know, my dad, he was hijacking an airplane in the top of Afghanistan when my mom, she gave birth to me.
Okay, so yeah. Are you all safe now?
I'm what?
Like, are you people safe?
Safe?
Because you told they got a hijack.
Wherever Muslims they go, there's nobody is safe. Even you as a Muslim are not safe with Muslims. Even Muhammad, he don't trust Muslims.
Okay, so...
Yeah. So now listen. So Allah, he squeezed Muhammad, right? And 3 times, and was hoping to accomplish.
Brother, listen. We'll go to next topic, okay?
What next topic?
Another topic. Come on.
Why you don't want this topic?
Like I have some doubts. Okay.
You have some doubt.
Can you explain?
I have a lot of doubt. You want some?
Yeah. First, I ask one doubt. You ask me one doubt.
Okay.
Khalas.
Okay. Is that Arabic word?
Yeah.
Khalas.
Yeah, actually, yes.
What khalas mean in Arabic?
Like over.
It's what?
Over. Complete.
Complete?
Yeah, it's hard to explain, but yeah.
Who taught you the Arabic language?
No.
So how you know that this word means complete?
Because I grew there.
You what?
Like I grew, like I spent my childhood in Arab place.
So in Arab place, when they say khalas, that means it is complete?
Yeah.
No, it means it's over. Not complete, nothing complete. Yeah. All right. So now you said you want to switch the topic. Okay, choose topic. You know, I'm not going, I don't want to be hard on you. Like, you know, no squeezing no more. Give me a topic. You can win with it.
Okay, so explain Trinity to me.
Explain what?
Trinity.
Trinity?
God system.
It's very simple. God is a three and one at the same time.
So, three people.
No. Did I use the word people?
No, I'm sorry.
Okay, so why are you adding word there?
Three
God
people.
Is a three and one at the same time. As an example, you, how many is within you as a person?
Nothing. I am one.
No, you are not. According to Islam, you are not.
Okay, so how many I am?
Isn't it Allah? He says he created you from you from water.
I mean, sorry, from mud actually.
Allah created you from water, correct? Allah created you from water and mud. He made a mud, correct?
No.
All right.
Yes,
and then
yes.
and
mud.
Then Allah and then Allah he breathed into Adam, correct?
What? Yes.
Okay.
That's how he
what,
made
so
Adam.
What he breathed into Adam?
What?
What Allah breathed into Adam? What he breathed?
Breathe. Wait, he created a normal human. Khalas.
I know. Khalas. Listen, don't say this word again. I mean, this is funny. Listen, Allah, he breathed what inside Adam? What he breathed?
Like all body parts, a normal biology.
He breathed. He breathed body parts. Breathe.
Yeah.
You Muslims,
breathe.
You breathe. You breathe body part.
Breathe. Like breathing.
Breathe.
Anyway.
You breathe in him. Okay, so here in the Quran, as an example, it says, so when I fashioned him, Allah speaking about Adam, I breathed into him. So what Allah breathed into him? His soul, correct?
Okay, next.
So now we have Adam and we have his soul, correct?
Okay.
Is his soul and Adam is one or they are two?
One?
No, they are two.
Okay, so can they live differently? Like,
no.
Can they live in two
Adam,
homes?
No, hold on.
Then why?
Adam, his name is Adam before even his soul is given to him. This is what the Quran is saying. So Allah gave him soul. So now Adam become two and one in the same time, correct?
No.
No, because Allah, he gave him a soul. Adam is already exist. He fashioned him. Look, he fashioned him.
Okay.
Who?
Is it written like two forms? A human has two forms.
No. What forms?
Then why?
What forms? Tell me. Maybe
you are telling soul.
Maybe
soul
I get you wrong.
Human.
No. Okay. Do you have a soul? You have a soul, right?
Yeah.
All right. So when your soul is taken away from you, is your body still you or not you? No more.
No. Like I'm dead.
Yeah, I know you are dead. You are dead anyway. But I'm saying that when your soul is taken away from you, is your body still you?
No.
No. So who is that body?
Okay.
Who is that body? You say no.
That things happen when I die, right?
I know you. I can shoot you right now if you want. No problem. That's easy. But this is not a question. I'm asking you. When you die, is your body? Do your wife sit next to you, cry on you and your body because this is you, or she don't do that?
That's me, of course.
Okay. So, but now your body is there, but your soul in different place. So now you are two, not one. The soul is out. The body is there.
Only after I die. Listen, only after
you see,
I die.
He, same before when Allah was creating you. He made the body first, and then he put the soul. So you are two, joined together. That's why we call it resurrection. Resurrection to do what? To reunite the body with the soul, correct?
Okay,
that's mean you are... So how you are two and one in the same time? Explain to me.
That's how human form is.
Now you answer yourself. This is how God is. God is a three and one in the same time. So if a human being can
you
be
only
two,
told me
hold
two,
on.
Right?
If a human being can be two and one,
two, right?
hold on. If a human being can be two and one in the same time, well, God can be three and one because he is almighty and he is all miracle. For nobody can question why you can, why you are like that. This is God. God says, I'm a three and one at the same time. Can your God be three and one? Can your God be three and one at the same time, or he cannot?
No, it's like we are underestimating God if we think like that.
So Allah cannot be three and one at the same time, correct?
Yes.
That means he cannot be God, because nothing limited to God. God can do anything he wants. He can be whatever he wants. So if God says, I'm three and one, because he's God, he can do it. But if I am not God, I cannot. Can I be here in China at the same time? No, I cannot, because I'm not God. But God can be. He can be everywhere. Is your God, Allah, is everywhere?
Yes.
No? Is Allah your Allah in the bathroom?
If he sees us.
No, Allah don't
see
you.
Right?
No, Allah don't see you. Allah right now, according to Islam, he is in the top of his chair, correct?
Throne, yeah.
Okay, so don't why you are saying to me Allah is everywhere? Why you are lying? He's not where, not anywhere. He's on top of a chair. He don't even, okay. According to Muslim, they don't dare to answer if he said or not. So now, going back to the Trinity, when a Muslim says, explain the Trinity for me, you're asking me to explain God. Well, God is a miracle, and nobody can explain miracle, because simply, we call it miracle because nobody can explain it. Like when God, he said, let be light, light was. How I can explain that to you? I cannot do that. Nobody can explain it.
So, like,
the power of God, my friend, the power of God, either you agree that it is beyond explanation, or you are a hypocrite and you want God to be explained. Can you explain to me why your God Allah have a hand as an example?
No, we can't.
So how come you want to ask the Christian's God how he can be three and one at the same time, but you don't dare to ask Allah why he have a hand? Okay, I will tell you, I have hand. And because I have a flu, there's a booger, hold on. Yeah, I just took it off. So I use my hand for my boogers. Allah use his hand for what?
Same, I guess.
He take boogers too?
No, like it's his wish, right?
So what he use his hand for?
We can't ask that because it's God.
So why you are being hypocrite asking the Christians how your God can be three and one at the same time?
I didn't ask. I'm just saying you explain. That's it.
I know. Nobody can explain God, my friend. Nobody can explain God. I mean, but how God can know what I did, even though I'm doing it at dark? Huh? Nobody can.
I have some doubts about Christianity, and I'm asking you. That's it.
All right. No problem. It's all right.
Okay.
So your God, he have hands. He have five fingers. He have a foot. And then the Muslim, they say to us, he's not a man. So what he is? Octopus.
So it's written in Quran that he have five fingers and hand and all?
No, in the Quran it says he have two hands. In the Hadith it says he have five fingers. I don't know why, by the way, because I have five fingers too. How come his fingers are the same number as my fingers? Is that because we both are coming from monkeys?
So I heard something new today, so let me research about it and explain to you later, okay?
All right, no problem. So tell me something you are sure from about your God.
About my religion?
About your God. And religion, you don't have religion. You are a Muslim. Muslim don't have religion.
Okay.
Yeah, Muslim don't have religion. You don't even know what Allah is mean. Do you know what Allah mean? You don't know.
Almighty. Simple.
Allah mean Almighty? Show me where you get this from.
You just told me
Allah cannot be three and one at the same time. So how you call him Almighty? He cannot. Almighty is the one he can.
Okay.
All mean all. Might mean power. So you just said to me, as an example, the Quran says Allah cannot have a son unless he have a girlfriend. So my God, he can have a son without a woman. Your God cannot have a son unless he have a girlfriend. He's like me, you know? Like me, exactly. I don't have a son because I don't have a girlfriend. Your God, Allah, is the same. So, your God, Allah, is not almighty. He cannot be God. Because God do not need anything to accomplish something. you know.
Listen. Listen.
Huh?
Okay. So does you like Christianity and Islam have same God?
No, we don't.
Okay.
Your God is stupid. Look what he said in the Quran. This, do you know the chapter 6, what the chapter is? What the word an'am mean? Do you know what the...
No, I'm sorry, no.
Mean animals.
Any?
Animals. An'am mean animals.
Okay.
So what kind of God, he speak about himself, he don't have a girlfriend in the chapter of the animals, unless he is a donkey.
Wait, what?
If this is a chapter about animals, why he is talking about himself there, is he an animal too?
See, listen, what does he tell? Like, I need to talk context, right? I'm sorry.
What context? The context, the chapter is about al-an'am, which means animals. All right. So why in the chapter of the animals, Allah speaking about he don't have a girlfriend, and this is why he cannot have a son?
Okay, I need the verse, I'm sorry. Like,
okay, chapter of the animals, chapter 6, verse number 101. Let me show you in the screen. You see my screen?
No. Yeah, I can see now, yeah.
All right. Okay, can you read it? Sorry, guys, I have a... So I mute the microphone when I want to cough. Okay, go ahead, read.
Okay.
How can Allah have a children if you don't have a girlfriend? What kind of God he say that?
Okay, so can human... Can be born without an woman?
Like, yeah, human? No, he cannot. Human, he cannot do that.
Okay, then that's what it means.
No, is Allah human? Is Allah human? Is Allah human like us? Is Allah human like us?
Where it's mentioned, like, listen. He is the originator of heavens and earth.
Uh-huh. And how he can have a children if you don't have a wife? So how he can be the originator? If he cannot originate even a baby without having a woman? When God created Adam, did he need a woman to create Adam? No. So the one who can create Adam, he can create a baby. Who care? Without a woman. God, he created Adam first and then the woman. Not the opposite. So here, this verse proving that Allah cannot be God. This is the logic of a human being. How can I have a son if I don't have a girlfriend? But that is me. But if I'm God, the God of the Christian, he do not need a woman to have a son. This is what the Christian believe. Jesus is not the son because God, he have sex with a wife and then they have a baby. His name is Jesus. No. So here your God, when he say he is the originator and yet he cannot originate a son without a woman, he cannot be the originator.
Okay.
That means Allah is false God. He's not God. He cannot be God. How he is the originator, he cannot make even a son. Making a son is very simple. Hey, say B. Hey, I want to have a son. B son. Son is there. So, in other words, your God is a potato. Do you agree with me that your God, Allah, is a potato? even potato do not need a woman to make a potato. The potato will make, branches come out from the potato, many potatoes. You put one potato in the ground, come a year after, you have many potatoes. There's no girl's friend. So potato can do better than Allah. A potato can make many potatoes, but Allah cannot make any potato without having a wife. Like who, guys, my name is Allah and I'm looking for a wife, because I want to have a son. I cannot have a son without a woman. She have to be in the age where she can give birth, please. And I prefer if she have seven nipples. which means she's a dog. What kind of God is God is? Potato is more strong than your God. Very powerful. You would put one potato in your yard will be full of potatoes. This is why you call Muslims potatoes, you know. They have no idea what they are. What happened?
Okay, so can I explain the words which you...
You want to explain? Even this one need explanation too?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I can explain.
Okay.
So basically, that was tells that...
Did you say basically?
We can't... Yeah.
What basically mean?
Yeah.
Why you are making it complicated?
Basically.
Don't use the word... Do you study DOS or JavaScript or anything?
No, I'm sorry, no.
Your God do not know JavaScript, I know it. So your God is the potato too. So listen, when you say to me, let me explain, even this one in discrimination, he says clearly, I cannot have a son unless I have a woman. That's it. I cannot have a son unless I have a woman. So Allah is a potato. He cannot have a son unless, even this one need explanation.
Can I explain?
Go ahead. But don't say basically. Don't say basically. I'm warning you. Don't say basically. Jump it. Okay. Skip it.
Okay. Okay. We should not underestimate God, right?
But God has to underestimate himself. He just said he cannot have a son unless he has a girlfriend. What are you talking about? Do you know how to read? It says, how can he? Allah is asking, questioning his ability. How can he? It's not me saying that. It's your God. How can he? How can that mean he's not God? Because I can say,
listen. That,
if he is
that
God,
verse tells that Allah cannot have son because he does not have a partner.
Exactly. Because he cannot have...
Because Allah is omnipotent. Listen, because Allah is omnipotent, okay?
Okay, hold on. Do the God of the Christians have partner to have a son?
No, of course.
Okay, so the God of the Christian must be true God. Your God, he need a partner to have a son. He cannot do it alone.
My God. I explain you. If you want, I'll explain you.
Hold on. What do you explain? You just did. You repeat yourself. Allah, he is saying, how can he have a son unless he have a girlfriend? So he cannot do it alone. My God, he can.
See, because he doesn't have a partner, right? He does not have a partner.
Okay, so Allah, he is saying, if he have a partner, he can have a son, all right?
No.
Yeah. So what is missing?
Because from starting, he doesn't have a partner, okay? Because he is one.
No, he have a son. He have a hold on. You see, your God have many partners. You know, first of all, when you're Muslim, you say shahada. You say that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his prophet, right? So by doing that, you are associating the name of Muhammad with the name of Allah. This is shirk.
No, I'm sorry.
Secondly,
we say Muhammad.
Hold on.
We say that Muhammad is last prophet.
Allah want to get married. He will marry from who? If you want to get married.
What do you mean?
If he says, how can I have a son if I don't have a girlfriend? So if he is not a human like us, why he is making it possible?
No, the context there is not what you think. It's there that because God doesn't have a partner, that's why he will not have a son.
All right, I understand. I don't have a partner too. That's why I don't have a son. Same.
Yeah.
Okay, but that's me, not me, but for me as a man. But if I am God, I do not need a partner. I can have a son. I can do anything I wish. So your God, he cannot accomplish anything by himself. This is what a man need. Man, he need a partner. Women need a partner to have a son. Man, for he is a man, created in a certain way, he is limited. So he can have a son only if a male have sex with a female. He cannot do it alone. Same for the female. So Allah is saying he is like us. He is a male. By the way, is he or she?
Okay.
What okay? Is he or she?
What God?
Your God, Allah, is he or she?
Sorry, it's omnipotent. It's omnipotent, like everything. It's omnipotent.
Impotent?
Omnipotent. Yeah, like you can search it on Google. I'm sorry.
What?
Omnipotent means everything.
Mean what?
Everything.
Allah is everything? That is Kamala Harris.
Wait, what?
Kamala Harris is everything, you know, has been burdened by what has been, you know. What do you mean everything? I'm asking you, is he or she?
There is no gender to God.
So why he call himself he?
Because the translation tells like that, but Arabic
no.
Quran doesn't tell like that.
Okay, read it for me in Arabic. Okay, as long as it's in Arabic, it's not like that. Okay, read it for me in Arabic.
Like that was?
Where in Arabic? You said it's in English, not in Arabic.
So can I read that in Arabic?
I don't know. You know, it's you who's saying that, not me. So you have to prove it. Where in Arabic it says he did not use he?
Okay, so I'll explain you.
What do you mean explain to me?
Basically,
I just said to you,
listen.
Which word in Arabic, which is like when the guy here translated he, where the word he in Arabic? You said it's not there, correct?
Yeah.
Well, every translation use the word he. So why are you using he if it's not he?
See, because the translation is wrong according to me.
Okay. Do you have
that's
one?
Why we read,
so can you name for me?
Listen,
can you name for me one translation is not wrong? Just one for this verse.
Like which?
What?
We believe in Arabic. That's why we read Quran in Arabic, but no other language. Not
what do you mean?
English,
so because okay, because
Arabic,
I don't know Arabic, you are taking
me,
because I don't know Arabic, you are taking advantage of me, making fun of me. Correct?
No, I'm sorry. No.
Can you bring somebody then? He speak Arabic so he can find out for us if it says that or not.
Okay. I'll bring it for you. You can also, because there is Arab Christian. I'll bring an Arab Christian. Okay.
Okay. I will bring one. Here we go. I got one. بديع السماوات والأرض أن يكون له ولد. You see it. له. You see له. له is he. له. He. For him. All right.
Okay.
So it is he. It is he. Wahua. Hua. He.
Okay.
He.
So you know Arabic.
He.
No, I don't. It's a miracle, you know. I just saw somebody push the button. Yeah. So now it says he. So is Allah now he or she?
Neither he nor she.
So why he keep saying he if he is neither? He's lying then. He's using fake gender.
What I know is huwa means he.
What?
Like what I know is huwa means he.
Exactly. Huwa mean he. Thank you. So Allah, when he say he and he is not he according to you, that means he's lying. You should not use the word he. He's not a man. You don't have a gender, you say it. So why he say he?
So like in Bible it's nowhere mentioned he.
No, it mentioned. No, it's mentioned.
Then
he Jesus.
Then what's
he,
the difference?
He Jesus.
So
he's a man.
God
Jesus.
Is he or
Jesus
he?
Don't you know that the Christian believe
Jesus
that
Jesus is a man
don't you know that the Christians they believe that God he came to us in the flesh as a man. His name is Jesus.
Okay.
Is he? He's a, yeah.
So
he came. He came as a male, perfect male. So now, Allah is a fake he. Jesus is a real he. Why Allah he used the word he if he is not he?
Because Like according to you, how do you express anything? Like instead of he or she, what do you tell? Like
sorry.
Who is originator of heavens?
My friend, listen.
Which phrase is better, according to you?
What originator? The guy, he cannot originate even like a potato. Listen carefully. We finish with the originator now. Why he's calling himself he if he is not he? He cannot even find a better word to call himself. I mean, he's limited in language too. Not only limited in not making have a baby without having a wife, he is limited in the language, so he cannot even use a language, or he create a phrase for his own, so he's limited. He have to use the word he. And look, it says here, how he can have a son if he don't have a wife? That means he is a female. Why he didn't say without a husband? Why Allah did not say, how Allah can have a son without having a husband? Why he choose a wife if he is not a male?
Okay.
What okay? If I say how I can have a son without having a woman, that means obviously I'm a man. Because two women cannot make a baby, buddy. Unless it's Kamala Harris, she can do that. So you can say, how can I have a son without having a wife if you are a male? But if you are a female, you will say, how can I have a son without having a man, a husband? So when you say to me, Allah is not a male, and then in the verse it says, how I can have a son without a wife, that means he is a male.
Okay, so basically it has a different context, I'm sorry.
What?
It has a different context.
No, there's no different context. It says, how I can have a son without having a wife. It's clear, in front of you. What context? Wife. He do not need, if he say the partner, it can be anything. It can be a donkey, it can be a goat, it can be anything. But he said the word sahiba. It's clear. It's a female. Girlfriend.
Okay.
So what okay?
I'll research about it. Okay, listen.
You will research.
I don't know more about this. I'll research. If I understood anything, I'll talk with you in my next debate, okay?
All right.
Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.